This week in Colombia, we have really focused on streamlining government. And one of the constitutional questions that we're going to put forward for the ballot is whether the governor and lieutenant governor should run together rather than running independently. By doing it this way, sending it to the voters to change our constitution allows more uniformity, it saves money, it allows a team approach, much like we see at the national level where a president and vice president run together for the high office. It would use that same logic here in South Carolina. The other part of the equation is for our superintendent of education. Should that position be elected as it is now, or should it be appointed by the governor? We're going to send that question to the voters as well as a constitutional change. And really that question, though, is which direction should we go? Should it be appointed or should it be elected? On the lieutenant governor and governor combination, that's just the question. So we're moving forward trying to make sure that for South Carolina, A, we save as much money as we can for the taxpayer, and B, that our government is as streamlined as it can be. I think all of these measures now are good moves. We have passed these in the House of Representatives before. They have met opposition in the Senate. I see a changing Senate. The Senate is more amenable to the changes that we're asking for in the House. So hopefully 2011 and 2012 will be great years for South Carolinians to be able to save tax dollars and to have a government that is more accountable to them and more streamlined. I look forward to working and talking each week about issues that we're dealing with here in the State House. As always, you can look me up on Facebook or you can always go to my website, GarySimrill.com.